you know, art. Like, art is always first for me.
Art. It's art. Ladies and gentlemen, are y'all ready for art today? What is good with y'all, man? It's your boy, Unseen. We back with another album reaction. It's the second part, baby. We here. Second part of, hey, yo, West Side Gun, Hitler Wears Hermes 8, Side B. You already know how we do, baby. This is a 20-track project. We are in for one. We are getting treated to greatness right now. Like, this is stacked. Side B, the conclusion, this is it. Like, we're done. This is it after, I mean, this is the end of Hitler. This is it. If you guys haven't already checked out my video, my reaction to Side A, man, that shit was special. I fuck with Side A heavy. I've been hearing this one is like, this is it. Like, this is the holy grail. This is the best one. Like, I've been hearing this all the time. Maybe that's just because West Side Gun talks a mean game, but I've been hearing this one is like way leagues above Side A. Before we get into this reaction to Hitler Wears Hermes 8 Side B, you guys can drop a like on the video, comment down below, subscribe for more, turn on those post notifications so you know when the next upload is, baby. You already know the vibes. Hey, without further ado, let's get into the video. Art, let's get into some art. Let's go. So track number one is an intro track. This shit's 30 seconds long, so We're gonna go to track two. All right, so apparently that first track was the intro to the intro track, because this next track we got is called End How You Start Intro. Two intro tracks, I'm cool with that. So we got 18 or so tracks to get into. All right, so we got track number three. This one is called Hell on Earth Part 2, featuring the Griselda members, the founders, Conway and Benny, man. I'm so glad we got another Griselda cut, because Claire's back off of Side A was different. So I'm excited for Hell on Earth Part 2. I didn't even know they had a part one of this bitch. But let's get into it, man. First real track. Let's go. Ooh, yep. Got it. Already got it. He knows. Can't you drink so much remixing? We fishes out of Oakland in the Rose. Might have been one of Felix. Stuck with a dealer's mentality. Bricks on top of squares on the bed. We work for God, fixed salary. I'm telling you, he's getting right to it. Let's go, man. Let's go. West Side Gun. He knows the vibes. Come on now. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, nah, they got. It's crazy that I'm still. Nah, they got the. Hold on. To go from that into Benny's verse, I'm telling you, West Side Gun just got that vision, bro. He just got the vision. He got it, bro. I'm still talking YOLO. Made a brick through yoga. I know about hard white and a Mexican flights. The Oklahoma, a pale heart. I'm Dale Earnhardt with a smoking motor. Black Sopranos. I took the O for La Costa Nostra. Like Benny, he's getting busy on this one. It's something light. It's not the best verse I've heard from him, but he's going crazy. I like this beat too. The beat is pretty cool. Let's listen to Conway, man. Let's go. Machine, bitch. Let's go. Arizona playing the field like the sun devil. I put some diamonds in Hundezel with them yellow. I got a shooter in New York, I call him Young Mellow. I got some trunk tape and one shovel, long money, talking billions, nigga, and I want several. Talk to him. This dude is, I will say, he's got better ad libs than Benny. And his references, like his metaphors and shit. Conway's getting busy. I like this track. I like how this is the first one too. I like how this is the first official track.
The fuck I look like putting the dress on.
Man.
Fucking crazy, nigga.
Man, nah, that I'm glad he addressed it. I'm spitting bars right there. I'm glad he addressed that. That just came natural. I swear to you. That just came natural. I had to cover my mouth because I just realized I spit some wordplay. When I seen the picture of him, I was like, bro, what is he like? I thought this dude was on the grimy shit. Why he doing that shit? Like, I still think that shit's a dress. I don't give a fuck. Like, that's damn near like some humiliation ritual on some shit. If y'all know, y'all know, man. All right, so we got track number four. This one's called Free Cutter, featuring Jay Electronica. Oh my God, we got Jay Elec. You gotta think West Side Gun putting together a classic already. We're not even five tracks in and this man's already putting together some greatness. Oh man. Produced by Jay Versace too. I was like, who even made this beat? Yeah, Jay Versace. Okay, this is stacked. Oh yeah, we can rap on this. Hey, yo, controller. This beat is so unique, bro. Like, this shit sound like I'm in an art museum, bro. It sound like I'm in the Louvre on some shit. I swear, this shit sound crazy. This is like, yo, this is fire. Please God, keep your head up on your sabbatical. Yeah. Yeah, like Griselda could finally enter the chat with that skrrr, do, 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 all over the tracks. Yeah. Reality, your time as your days blow by. It'll be like Yoda with Luke and the day go by. Hey, this dude is, I'm telling y'all, Jay Electronic is just different, bro. He's different. Did you peep that Star Wars shit? Did you peep that shit? It'll be like Yoda with Luke in the day go by. Like, bro, because that's like one of the planets, I think, or some shit in Star Wars. And day go by sounds like day goes by, the day goes by. Pfft, wordplay? Come on, man. Say you should read theology, right? And maybe this is a reach, but if you study Star Wars gets a lot of influences from ancient Kemet. So theology, ancient Kemet. The thing with ancient Kemet is ancient Kemet influenced Christianity, if y'all don't know that. Christianity took a lot of shit from Kemet, which is Egypt, right? It's just me, the machine, Westside, Hermes, the Hitler, J-Dawg, Spittler, burning niggas live with the scripture. Like Gangstar and Freddy Fox told you, it's the militia. I spit it for that Mac, that mouth, that Cali open, that Fisher. All right, that track was fire. I'm fucking with that track. So far, it's all hits right now. All hits, baby. Let's go. All right, so we got track number 5. This one's called Richie's, produced by Mad Fucking Lib. Different. Madlib? Nah, okay. And there's no features. West Side Gun, you better bring some fucking bars. You got Madlib on this bitch. Come on, let's go. Come here, take my hand. Let me flex. Ooh, nah. You are the Egyptian change on. I get my neck for you, bro. David Choppins knew I sold dimes. He brought me $8 in my cell. I had to sell me. My celly had the lobsters test us out the window. Everybody this beat is. I'm telling you, it's the production. The production is different, bro. This shit is so clean. The way Madlib just chops up these samples like that. Oh my goodness. Ooh. You don't even gotta rap, bro. This is fire. He's goated. Like, this is fire, bro. For the sake of replay value, like, I may not bump this in the whip. I may not. But, like, to be on an album, this is a song you want on your album. This contributes to the acclaim. This contributes to it being, having this GOAT status. This song is prestigious. That's the word I can use to describe it. This shit is prestigious, bro. The interludes are different. He on his, hey, my man's is getting on his French shit. He's really on his art shit right now. You know what I'm saying? He's really on that art. He's on that E, François, E, oui, oui, monsieur. Like, he's really about it right now. That's my French impression. I think that shit sounds fire. This shit is crazy. This song goes crazy. So far, like, I'm not gonna skip this one. This shit is not bad. I want to get that straight, because I get a lot of flack, like, for not liking some of West Side Gun's, like, styles. This shit is still good. All right, so we got track number 6. This one is called Julia Lang. I think this was a single, and I never got around to listening to it, which actually is good, because it's on the album, you know what I'm saying? This one's featuring Trapaholics. Oh, it's featuring the, damn, son, where'd you find this? Trapaholics. Bro, hey, that's fire. That's fire. This is goated. Like, to get that shit is just iconic in and of itself. Just like West Side Gun is, right? You know what I'm saying? This, hey, let's go, man. Let's go. Trapaholics mixtape. Oh my God. Just hearing that. Oh. Yo, I slept. Oh, just hearing that shit. Yo, this shit is legendary. For real, for real. Whoa, bro. Trapaholics, real trap shit. Oh yeah. Different. That shit's different. You have to put that in if you got trap ball. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. I don't even gotta say it. Y'all just know. If you know, you know. If you know, you know. Damn, son, where'd you find this? You have to.
Trapaholic.
Dude, I love this shit. I love this. This shit is so iconic. It's so iconic. And it's not even like it's corny. I don't even think this is corny. I really don't. I think this shit's dope. I think it's dope. And Westside Gunn's got energy. He's bringing the energy. This beat, this production. Yeah, this is the sound that I like to hear, man. This is it. Let's go. You had to put that damn somewhere. You have to put that. That's iconic. That's art right there. That's art.
I'm putting down to my kneecaps. I sold my first square to shit. Touch my soul. Listen here. Gianni, get you in. Wrap my bricks in here. Vision clear. Sell a million bricks. I'll be a billionaire.
Oh, that's fire. Okay. I like those end bars because he's just, once again, he talks that fly shit. Thing with West Side Gunn is sometimes he draws out his songs a little bit too long. This one, not drawn out long at all. Perfect length. Perfect length. I would have gotten tired if this was any longer. I would have gotten tired of it for real. I'm glad he knew when to stop on this. Got track number 7. This one is called Celine Dion. Ooh, shout out Celine Dion. Featuring Flea Lord, Heme, and Chase Fetty. This is up and coming talent right here. I just want to let y'all know, man. Oh.
Fuck.
Here it is. Here it is. Bro, this brick of this man, no cherry land roll. Used to rock Pebble Beach, and then we came home. Listen to the background synths. Listen to the synths in the background on this beat. It sounds so fucking like immaculate. It sounds like I'm in a church, bro. It sounds like some choir shit. It sounds like some fucking orchestra type shit. Ooh, this is gonna be filthy.
This that 7-1 murder shit. My niggas sell dope and murder shit. 130 to life, and he ain't tell him shit. Felon shit. We all grew up on that ghetto shit. Robbing niggas for fun, and now my bezel living ghetto rich.
That part right there. You hear that beat? You hear the beat go switch like that? Yo, Heme is getting busy too. I'm not trying to take away from Heme. I just like this production a lot.
Get an extra headshot just for turning sex. We suicidal. Lost soldiers in the beef with rivals. Told my mama that I love her, loading up my rifle.
Bro, this shit is different. Do you hear that? Like, bro, I can legit cry. This shit sounds so good. It sounds so goddamn good. I love this shit. This beat is goated. This is my favorite beat so far. Heme is just coming with like the heartfelt lines, like the street shit, the storytelling. Oh my goodness. I don't want this one to end. I'm cool if this beat just loops. I'm cool with it.
I turn 50 in the 80 if you whip it good. That's a fact. Chop it up, then I'm in your hood. Like the engineer, I serve your bitch while she with the kids. I'm in the flips like
Chase Fetty. Okay, this is Chase Fetty. Yo, he's got the voice for this shit. This shit sound, he sound nice on this one. Yo, this shit sounds so ill, bro. Like, this sound like the posse cut. This is like a real posse cut, for real, for real. This sound like the I don't want to call this the modern day One Train, but it gives me like a One Train kind of vibe. With the way that this, especially with the production you could say kind of sounds similar with the drums and everything. It sounds a little similar.
Never stuffed dope in a bowl of rice. You got knocked and started singing like Hova's wife. This street shit is like a roll of dice, nigga. And I'm here for that head crack. Over a little cheese, get your head tapped, nigga. I can't stand rats. And these shells is like pesticides on them. I'm pushing weight, trying to exercise on them. These bitches think you a chicken box, cause they got some breasts and thighs on them.
Chase Fetty is going crazy. I like Chase. Yo, what an introduction to Chase Fetty. Shout out to Westside Gunn. He knows what he's doing. Marketing his team like this. Even BSF he's marketing from Heme. Like, bro. Chase Fetty's going crazy. Chase Fetty's different. Chase Fetty is just different. It's over. This is, yo, sonically, this is sounding way better than side A. The piano like that? The piano is something serious when you got Westside Gunn over your shoulder curating this bitch.
Popping out that former slide to Saxon Fifth. Skipping out that bitch with 20 racks of shit. Off-white song, Dior gone, swam bully on it. People love me feeling strong.
Yeah. This is what I want to hear. this is it right here. This is like peak West Side Gun, peak curator shit right here. In his fucking bag. Shout out to Flea Lord too. He's going stupid on this. So far, that's my favorite track, for real, for real. I think that one might be my favorite right now. That first beat is actually insane. That first one is crazy. The verses were amazing. And the second one is just the icing on the cake, for real. All right, so we got track number 8. This one's called Best Dressed Demons, featuring Makami, produced by Derringer. Stacked. Another one. This has got to be it right here, man. Come on, this is different. Let's get into it. Oh, I heard quiet that'll make you back to screaming. Best dressed demons, Gucci, Louis, Prada, and Sesame, less famous. Used to do the bower, now you fleeing the scene, and then them big ass niggas, police. Makami just sounds so good on like every beat he touches. It sounds like his voice just fits this shit. I feel like I'm listening to a painting, if that makes sense. You know what I mean? Like, I just get these like France vibes. Nobody never did it this deep. Niggas mention me. I don't mention niggas. Niggas is cheeks. Press for triggers. Triggers get squeezed. Oh my god, that shit's comedy. That shit's comedy. But Makami, hey, it's not a bad verse. Not the best verse, but it's not a bad one either. Did his job. Did his job, man. Let's go. I'm at the fountain, blue, proud of mountain boots, still collars. I'm getting fat food. She threw Chanel visors, roast stone at my stove. I parked the Range Rover, Larry, mini tech in the Grateful Dead, Michael Mary's. The fashion, talking all this fashion shit, bro. The Chanel visors, the fucking, I'm hopping out the Range Rover, parking the Range Rover, the silk collars, the Prada mountain boots. Like, what more do you want? Like, tell me this is West Side Gun without telling me this is West Side Gun, bro. For real, for real. This is it. This is him right here. This is him. That verse from West Side Gun was dope, bro. Once again, he's sticking to that piano instrumental. He's sticking to that piano sound. I like that, continuing it from the last track. Now, if he really knows what he's doing, if I really fuck with his vision, if he really knows the vibes, he'll switch it up now. He probably won't have the heavy pianos on the next track. That's just my prediction. I know he knows the vibes. All right, so we got track number 9. This one's called Forest Lawn, featuring 2 Chainz. Trope. 2 Chainz and Armani Caesar. Shout out Armani Caesar, Griselda. You know the vibes, man. Let's get into it. Produced by Camouflage Monk. He's had some crazy production over both sides of this album, for real. Shout out to Camouflage Monk, man, for real. He's going crazy. I'm gonna be real with y'all. I think I've heard like a couple of snippets from Armani Caesar, and I'm not a huge fan of her, but if you Griselda, I guess I gotta respect you. You know what I'm saying? If you Griselda, I respect it. You care about the art. You care about the culture. I know 2 Chainz cares about the culture. Shout out to 2 Chainz, man. He's one of my favorites of all time. And him on features is different. I'm just saying it now. It's different. Look at that. There's not a lot of piano in this. I told y'all, he knows. Yeah. This instrumental doesn't sound like some shit you could rap on. It just sounds abstract. We're into the abstract part of this album now. It sounded a little abstract because how many kicks there are within that time period, it's almost like there's too many to even get in like a punchline or anything. This is interesting, man. Everybody wish they was a jumpsuit was undercover. Got the best work on my mother. You want to know some shit? This shit sounds like it could slap if you just change the pacing of this to like some 1.25, 1.5, 0.75 type shit on YouTube. You know what I'm saying? If you just speed this one up a little bit, this could sound fine. Like, this shit might be a problem if you speed this one up. But it sounds like he's making it work. He's making it work. It's not, once again, it's just songs like this can get drawn out for me. This shit's 5 minutes long. This one might get drawn out for me. Running so tall, like we on some stilts or some tippy toe hopping the fence. Probably, I probably in my wrist. Mention my name when you pull out the list. A leader score, a couple assists. I'm in the four, surrounded by bricks. I told y'all 2 Chainz on features is different. Bro, and I'm getting proved wrong. I stand corrected. Maybe you can rap on this one. You just gotta come with a faster flow. It sounded nice. It sounded real nice. Extendo is peeking out. The lookout is peeking out. You know I ain't preaching. Mama, my mental, they gotta come see me now. Tony. Fire. That's fire. You can't even lie. 2 Chainz feature game is so crazy. Like, think about all the legendary songs he's been featured in. Ali Boumaye, 3500 fucking problems on the hook. Like, this fool is literally, he's dropping triple doubles every feature. This fool's dropping 60 on every feature. He goes crazy. All right. Hey, you gotta chill. Armani Caesar's talking that talk right there for the Queens. Okay, I fuck with that. She must have heard me saying I ain't really fuck with her like that. She must have heard me because, hey, she's low key bringing it right now. Saint Laurent, it ain't even out yet. I ain't shopping at no fucking outlet. I'm alone with my hands outstretched. Living room with a Sasha couch set. Okay, I'd rather hear her over Megan Thee Stallion. I'm just saying, I'd rather hear this shit. And this shit could probably be the shit that she's rapping about. Because let's be real, we know what the industry promotes. The industry promotes the fuck shit, the destruction of pretty much melanated people. They promote that shit. Armani Caesar ain't talking like that enlightened shit that we talk about on this channel, right? But she's talking about like the clothes and shit. I feel like her rhyme scheme is better than Megan Thee Stallion and Cardi. Like, she can actually rhyme. She's like a lyricist MC. Cardi B, Megan Thee Stallion, like, get them out of here, bro. She can rap. I'll say it confidently. Armani Caesar can rap circles around Cardi B and Megan Thee Stallion. It's that simple. The beat was interesting because I thought it wasn't going to work, and it kind of worked out for him in the end. I thought it was going to backfire, but it worked out. So we got track number 10. This one's called Why I Do Them Like That. This one's featuring Billy Esco, I think who just signed a Griselda. I think that's another Griselda signee. And then Keisha Plum. So shout out Keisha Plum. Yep, we already know. Ooh, back to the pianos. I'm telling y'all, he knows the vibes. Oh my god, if this shit drops like I think it's gonna drop. Yup, yeah. He's listening. This is it. Hey, thank you, Fly God. Thank you. This is it right here, bro, for real. This is it. The pianos, I told y'all, even in the side A, the pianos that got the drums are gonna be the best tracks on these projects. I told y'all, the grimy piano shit is different. Let's go, man. Let's go. Let's go. Shout out to fucking Camouflage Monk. Another Camouflage Monk track produced. Let's go, man. Simple. I love this shit so much. I love it. I love this shit. I love it. This is it. This is West Side Gun at its best, bro. I'm like legit going to cry. No, I'm not. I'm just playing. But like, you just hear me. Like, I'm just full of joy right now because I know this is. You just know when a rapper's at their best, especially when the rapper isn't even like that big of a rapper like that. When he's a curator, you know this is his shit. Y'all know it. I know you know it. I know you know this is where he's best on. Don't even act like he's better on those fucking loops. This is his shit, bro. Oh, man. I'll go to my grave with this one. I will defend West Side Gun saying he raps better over this shit than over some, like, 1970s sample from like, some jazz musician with no drums or anything. This is the shit he raps better on. Easy. My man said, "Dick sucks at the Four Seasons." His core, bro, his hooks are the funniest shit ever. Walking around the house, dirty Glock with some clean bricks. Clean Gucci socks past the mop, help me sweep shit. Fucking in my flops with my shorts on backwards. She loving in the bed, it's 10,000 on the mattress. Oh, bro, West Side Gun just knows talent. He's signing talent right now. Billy Esco? Like, I'm gonna be real with you. I don't know who the fuck this is. But he's going crazy. Yo, shout out to West Side Gun for real. He's really just like, he's blowing my mind with this part. I know why people say this is the better side of the album. He's blowing my mind right now. There's maybe only been like one miss.
Like 01 Nelly.
Yeah.
My flow heavy, the tie breaking through the levee. We was never worried, they was never ready. Huh, you never steady. You wish you was like a paddle boat. Claim you captain, but you looking like your paddle broke away. Was
this dude, yo, Billy Esco is going crazy. This is, yo, he's flowing. He's got bars, like he's really just putting together lines right now. He's just throwing in the references to Air Force Ones, Nelly, like my flow heavy, the tide breaking through the levee, talk about water, claim you a captain, a paddle boat. Like he's just keeping the scheme. He's keeping the schemes together. Shout out to Billy Esco, man. He's going crazy. Hey man, this shit goes crazy. This song is fire. This is on the playlist. Easy. Easy. All right, so we got track number 11. This one's called R.I.P. Bergdorf, featuring Makami again. Let's go. Another Makami feature. Let's go, man. Hey, let's get into it.
Sometimes a junkie don't fiend proper. Opposition jumpy off the
E-drop. Oh my God.
Shoppers looking for smoke. We got T-guns, the D-dopper pushing the ball. She got knee knocked it.
Bro, Makami just coming straight in like that? Different. The rhyme scheme is crazy. And it's over an abstract beat. So here we go. I think this is our first ounce of the loops. We're getting loopy. Let's go.
2 years, you know it's Tony. In vain, I buy 100 shots out the stony. Part of my slime. He just showed a brick, but only now it's real. What's your life like, nigga? Mine's just real.
Hey, my. Oh, my God, bro. He's going. Yeah. Like, I'm not a huge, once again, this is the shit I don't like. I don't like loops like this. This isn't that bad. When it comes to the loops, I know when some shit sounds terrible. West Side Gun and Makami, the way that they're rapping on this one, they're making it work.
It's a black swan event, not a black tie fair. This is fashion rebel drip, no cat by a pair. See McQueen split, the old seems bad. Max Mara was scared. Donna Karen, mascara was smeared. Oh, that kind of shit.
Makami is just a special talent, for real, for real. Like, there's no one that sounds like him. Once again, bro, I'm not a huge fan of this instrumental, like the Sonics like this, but the thing is I know people fuck with this. I know this is a lot of people's favorite songs. The tracks that I cannot stand always seem to be people's favorites, like every fucking time. So this is probably one of them. But this is cool. I'm not hating on this. It's just not my style. All right, so we got track number 12. This one's called TV Boy, produced by Beat Butcher and Derringer. I think this one was a single, and I didn't listen to it, so thankfully we got it right here on the full album reaction. So let's get into it, man. Yo, the production's gotta go stupid right here. Come on now, let's go. Got it. He's back. This is it. You gotta take a little break. This is it right here. This is the grimy shit I fuck with right here. This is that grimy shit. Easy. Let's go. This is not my favorite, but it's better than that last track. I'm gonna just be real with you. I like this shit more. I think it just sounds better. My honest opinion, man. That street storytelling mixed with that fashion grimy shit is a mean combination, bro. Nasty. This is some real, like, this is for real, for real, for real. This is like very, very reminiscent of the 90s. So 90s. And I love it. I love it. Shout out to West Side Gun, bro. He's really not missing like that. I can listen to these songs again, for real. And you know me with West Side Gun is I need to be able to listen to this shit again. I can't just say it's good for the first listen and then just like not listen to it again. I gotta be able to revisit. Gotta be able to revisit art. All right, so we got track number 13. This is the one I've been looking forward to the most, I'm pretty sure. Survivor Series 95, featuring TF, who was on Schoolboy Q, Tookie Knows 2, goes crazy on that song. Jay Worthy, my Bay Area guys right here, right? Jay Worthy, and my mans, my fucking guy, my favorite rapper out of the Bay right now. One of my own, like, really my only favorite rapper out of the Bay Area. This dude is talented. Larry June. Good job, Larry. You're doing good, Larry. Hey, 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 hey. Keep it going, Larry. Suck it to me. Let's go, bro. I'm so excited for this fucking song. You don't understand. You want to know who has the two best ad-libs in rap right now? Larry June and Westside Gunn. No order. These are the two best rappers with the two best ad-libs on one song. Like, this is it. This is it right here. This is the dream. This is like, you could say this is a dream collab for real. Literally the two best ad-libs in rap right now, outside of maybe Currency. Like, yo, this shit. Just make a prediction right now. My man Larry June, he about to be doing numbers. He about to be doing numbers. Let's go. Yeah. Oh, I like this flow. I like that flow, Westside Gunn. Okay, you switching it up. You coming with that, like, that fast flow. That fast flow right there. He sounded like one of these newer rappers. Talk. Talk that talk. He gotta talk that talk. They for real the new Rockefeller, bro. Like, do you understand who they got signed right now? Boldy, Benny, Conway, Larry. I'm pretty sure Larry just signed. Like, Jay Worthy. I know Jay Worthy. Fucking Makami. Who else? Rome Streets. Like, they got everybody, bro.
Palace jacket matched the army fatigue. I took a peek to the sky for my niggas who cease. Street legend worldwide, really am who I be. That's why I'm good in every sanction where they chunk up the beat. I hit the county main line and really said where I'm from.
I like this, bro. I like this. I just think the beat could be better, but once again, it's just, this is the stamp of Westside Gunn, so I gotta fuck with it. You know what I'm saying? You just gotta fuck with this shit. The fact that he's even got Jay Worthy and Larry on this, oh, okay. Here we go. We're here.
Big press, we talking full court. This the staple center. Niggas got staples in their stomach. We're the bullet center.
I can't believe a Bay Area rapper is spitting bars like this. Bay Area rap has never been about, like, for real, these hard-hitting lines like that. Never, never. I can speak for it. I know for a fact it's always been about the hyphy shit. It's never been about, like, saying lines like that, except for guys like the Jacka and shit, maybe. But, like, still, Jay Worthy, yeah, let's go, man.
Gun, I love you, Damo.
Oh. Hey, 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 hey. I told you, Larry June. Good job, Larry. You're doing good, Larry. Keep going, Larry. This dude is such comedy, bro. I love fucking Larry June. Let's get into greatness, man. Let's go. Let's go. You better live up to it, Larry. I know you watching, Larry. You know what I'm saying? This is comedy, bro. I'm having fun listening to this shit. Let's go.
Mostly transport the kicks in the caravan.
Yeah.
Toys hit the block. Niggas grab, tuck the blast. 5 years old when I see my first crack deal.
Numbers. Numbers. We doing numbers at 5 years old. We just do numbers. Oh my god, bro. Larry June. He just knows. He's just so stylish with this shit. And I feel like he just matches Westside Gunn's energy with this fashion shit, with this, like, you know, the entrepreneur shit. Yeah, the lifestyle shit. Let's go. Listen to the ad-libs in the background, too. You just hear the, hey, 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 hey. You hear the, good job.
I never cried for the recognition. I went and got it. You niggas peppin', living with your mama. Lying to the bitch. Probably why the game water.
Talk to him. Numbers. Good job. He said, good job. Keep going, Larry. I told you, bro. Like, this dude is, bro. And he's saying some real shit, too. He just said, you know what? Since we on Westside Gunn, it's time to do numbers.
Gun flash like Mardi Gras. Long nights, long flights. I've been grinding my whole life. And I'm gonna keep grinding till my wrist busting like strobe lights. Kill it.
Fire. TF, that's fire. That's fire. Man, this song all around was amazing. All around amazing. I will say, I think if there was a different beat, I would have loved it even more, but still, the verses were amazing. Good job, Larry. You're doing good, Larry. Good job, verses. Good job, West Side Gun. All right, so we got track number 14. I've also been looking forward to this one the most because of his performance on Side A with Perry. This one's called Eddie Kingston featuring Rome Streets. Rome Streets is just that guy, pal. I even said it in my last video. I said it. He's that guy. He's next up. I'm going to say it. He's next. Rome Streets is next. I don't even got to listen to the song, and I know it. Let's go, man. It's over. Hey, yo. Not even 5 seconds. I already know. It's over. Niggas ring for dope who hadn't dropped your work. It couldn't swim. It's like my wrist be automatic. Yours is tragic. Pistol plastic, pistol addicts. Bring moves, flip your- Listen to that piano work, bro. That piano work. Oh my fucking God. That's some real Griselda shit right there, if I've ever heard some. I'm talking wrong things, right things. With the M16, he only 19. He order for 5 fiends, manslaughter on your recorder. You know the vibes, B. You know the fucking vibes, Rome Streets. You know the fucking vibes. Come on. I told you. He's just that guy. He's that guy. This is art. Murder when I arrive on the scene. Shit get dangerous. No famous shit. Became the fan favorite. You fool spitting falsified flows. It's all flavorless. What did I say? Rome Streets is next. He's next. He's next up. I'm telling you. I just know it. Like, I know talent when I see it. I predicted Kirk Knight blowing up. I predicted Logic blowing up in 2014. And I'm going to make one right here. Rome Streets is next. Especially when you got West Side Gun backing you. It's over. He's it. This is it. The punchlines are there. The fucking flow is crazy. He's got the rapping voice for this shit. Like, he just... Bro, you could see the potential. I just see it. I see it, bro. I see this shit for real. Smoke the trees out the Bible page. My brain waves is reckless. Rome chapter 2, verse 3. Said, watch the way you step and spray the weapon. Shells go through fly guy Avarex. It's over. I just caught the wordplay right there. Rome chapter 2, verse 3. Say, watch the way you step in. Because of Romans chapter 2, verse 3, I gotta look up the Bible verse now. You know what I'm saying? What if that's a reference to the Bible verse? Oh, I just looked it up. Romans 2, 3, talking about God's righteous judgment. And he said, watch the way you step in. Because it's about righteous, you know what I'm saying? You gotta be righteous. You gotta be righteous out here. So you gotta watch the way you're moving. Oh my fucking God, bro. Turn with dope pal, the cheddar getter, or make all of the hoes go down. Bet against the squad, you pick the worst lane. Stash your dough from the plate that I ate off like Hitler first name. Okay, yep. Rome Streets is probably my favorite because of this, just the wordplay like that. You know what I'm saying? Stashing dope from the plates I ate off like Hitler first name. Adolf Hitler and then ate off the plates. Okay. Slip. Went from fleeing many felony charges to fortunate. Fly fashion rebel fucking on your fiance. Living fast for the alliteration. You want someone who's gonna be the rising star of these two projects? Rome Streets is making a case for it. Work on my aim to be a sharp shooter like Bret Hart. Ooh. When my shit come on, it's the best part, nigga. Fuck out of here. Talk to him, Rome Streets. I know that. Fuck out of here. You said it on Side A. You're going to say it on Side B. You got to finish off right. On the playlist. It's on the playlist. You already know. Rome Streets. Different. West Side Gun. Different. All right. So we got track number 15. This one's called Oster Tag featuring Stove God Cooks, who was literally on pretty much every fucking track in Side A. So Stove God Cooks, our first appearance on Side B, produced by Alan the fucking Chemist. You already know how much I fuck with Alchemist. Go check that Boldy James reaction. You're gonna see how much I really fuck with Al. Don't make me send my dog through there in a UConn mask. Husky nigga hanging out the two-door bands. Ooh, UConn Husky. Newborn bag. When they were scared to get it through the mail, man, I went Utah Jazz. They said, Stove, you think you... Alchemist is in his bag right now. And y'all know I don't like beats like this without a lot of drums, right? This is one of those loops, but this loop is fucking filthy. This shit is filthy, and Stove Got Cook sounded nice over this one. This shit sound like some opera house type music. Yo, just listen. It sound like you in an opera house.
Just know I jumped in and killed. Bitch, I'm Roddy Piper.
Just know that.
They love my album like I died.
Like I died.
I'm 30 kilos high. I brought the stove alive.
Yeah.
Winds like this. Woo, feel like when the Pistons had Chauncey Billups.
Yeah. Okay. He knows the vibes. Stove Got Cooks went crazy on this. Shout out to Stove God Cooks for real. I still got to peep his Reasonable Drought mixtape. People say that's one of the best mixtapes of 2020. I got to peep that one. West Side Gun wasn't even on that track. That's how you know my man's the curator. You know what I'm saying? Letting Stove God Cooks shine on this one. Shout out to Alchemist. Yo, that's a filthy combo. Alchemist and Stove God Cooks. Filthy. Filthy, bro. Hey, that song was cool. A cool little 2-minute track. I'm cool with that. I'm all right with that one. All right, so we got track number 16. This one is called Monk. Edward, I think it's referencing the artist Edward Monk. So yeah, shout out to Edward, my mans. Produced by Conductor Williams, the GOAT Conductor. Let's go, man. Let's get into it. Conductor's beats are so fucking weird to me, like, but they're cool. It sounds dope. It's just, you don't hear shit like this.
Hey yo, so many niggas I love got life.
This is what, so yep. This is West Side Gun right here, and I'm not a huge fan of this type. This is the one I'm not really a fan of, but this is the one that I know people fuck with. So if you fuck with this, just know you got a crazy taste in the music.
Eiffel, you know how life go. I came home violated, you know the psycho. Fiends hit the dope and fell up like the scene, Michael.
That sample is crazy. I can appreciate the production side of it, but as an overall song, it just, I don't feel the need to want to listen to this one when I just heard a song like Eddie Kingston. I'm sorry, you know what I mean? I'm just sorry. But once again, they titled this song Monk, right? This is some art shit right here. This is art.
Soon I'm like Roger Staubach, lemon pepper hot mix, soft flats. You never wore that.
Ooh, okay.
Just how many days you got in front of you?
Okay, you got vocals.
Live the way you wanna.
This sound like some, just like some feel good, like just laid back type of song. It sounds dope though. Shout out Conductor. Shout out West Side Gun. His rapping is actually not that bad on this song. It's just, the overall product I'm just not a fan of compared to other tracks on this project. All right, so we got track number 17. This one is called 99 Avi Rex featuring Stove God Cooks and AZ. Stacked, bro. Produced by DJ Green Lantern. Stacked. West Side Gun is stacking this bitch. Oh my fucking God. Don't be a loop. Give me some drums. Please give me drums.
Still got the birds going crazy. I'm tapped in. Wheels all broke past tense. Now we dance bricks. Hermes alligator jacket. The Mac 10.
Okay. I like Stove Got Cooks on the hook is actually not that bad. There's some hooks that he just sounds atrocious on. But this one, he sounds pretty nice on. I'm cool with it.
Back in them tenements, backtracking my innocence. Crack was the genesis, G-packs and Guinnesses. Max on the premises. All I envision is stacks when I reminisce. In the mix is mood swings, you do things.
I cannot stand beats like this. Like, I just don't like this shit. But AZ is just flowing. Peep the rhyme scheme, the syllables. Reminisce, premises, genesis, tenements. Like, you gotta appreciate rhyming. You gotta appreciate, like, for real, penmanship. Different. Just listen to his rhyme schemes. Like, this is what makes him one of the best of all time, for real.
The Blake and Sutter side, look what a vibe. Mock the presence with my mother eyes. I come alive. Undenied his GOAT status, the most dappest.
GOAT status, he said it himself. GOAT status. The fact that he can make this type of beat sound, like he can make the song sound good, that goes to show how good of a rapper you are. You can still make shit like this sound dope.
Blurry, peep the obituary. To fuck the world, you gotta switch it for missionary.
Oh my God, bro. Like, he just icing on the cake with that line right there. To fuck the world, you gotta switch it from missionary. Different. Different. I made two feet, smack back to everyone, got a 50. Hate me down at the Whitney. Piss the staircase, piss the elevator. I feel like you need these songs in the album. You need to diversify the sound. As much as I don't really like this type of sound, it needs, like, I'm realizing it's necessary. It's necessary. Because it almost adds to West Side Gun's versatility. Spend 700 on jewels, my neck amazing. Rest in peace, Sheen Gun. Rest in peace, Bacon. Okay. And the thing is like, you hear Stove God Cooks coming in right there, just end the song right there. I don't want to hear Stove God Cooks again. I've already heard him twice. I don't need to hear his slow chorus one more time. I don't need to hear it. This is where songs like this get drawn out for me. The song is at 3 minutes and 23 seconds when West Side Gun ends his verse. Just end the song in the next 20 seconds. Do not stretch it out another minute. All right, so we got track number 18. This one is called The Fly Who Couldn't Fly Straight, featuring Tyler, the Creator. Man, Tyler and West Side Gun, we already know, 327, baby. That's the song right there. Shout out to Tyler, man. Hey, this song's only a minute 46 seconds, so we could be in for some greatness right here. I like the length of this one. I like how we're picking a shorter track. I like this. Let's go. I got soul, niggas ankle high. Think you that big step or fuck around. Get your ankles tied. I'm hot, boy. I'm from the depths of hell where you can't survive. A cold day for like a good oven with bacon pies. Yeah. Bitch chilling like I sing about you. Remind you got it bad. To hear Tyler, the Creator rapping is so refreshing. Like, I love when this dude actually wants to rap. Whenever rappers start to sing, I feel like they were just always better when they rapped. Like, in Tyler, the Creator, is just, I think he's better when he raps. They got so much room and psilocybin. How you doing? How you doing, bitch? When the money stop and check the rings. Yeah. Like some running cops, check the doors, butterfly, like when tummy drops. T with that West Side Gun, you get your mama. Oh, okay. See, that's some light. I like that too. It's not too much and it's not too little. I like that shit. Supreme Pipe X's for measurements, devilish. Thousand round drum, fun, your head spin. Exorcist, treacherous. If I was doing that, niggas get slimed out like egg yolk. I got some contacts to take. I don't play that boy on time. Oh, Tyler got a nut. I like this, bro. The production's good. The structuring of this song is nice. They're just trading bars. You know this is what we fuck with. We fuck with the bars. I love that this is a song on the album. I love how short it is because I can listen to it again and it's so convenient for me. Got too much paper when overtime and I ain't signed out. I'm that boy. If you need proof, press the rewind now. So go get a map, go get lost, nigga, and find out I'm out here. Yeah. Yep. You need that. You need that song on this album. You need that shit. Because that's a hit. It's not a miss, bro. And it's just another song added to this project that's a hit. All right, so we got track number 19. We got my boy again on this bitch. This one's called Big Al featuring Rome Streets, bro. It's like the final track. You know what I mean? The final, like, real song to listen to and shit. And you end it with Rome Streets. That's how I know you fuck with greatness, West Side Gun. Put up a crack of eulogy, gunpowder on my Louis V. Got questions with no answers, like, is life just a lucid dream? It's harder to do right besides this rapping. I'm attuned with schemes. My spoon, the stamp on the package was new regime. Put it in the wax paper, wrapping it straight to the fiends. He just makes it sound good, bro. Like, I don't know what to say anymore, Rome Streets. Like, you're taking the words out of my mouth, bro. For real. You're next. You're just next. Free my niggas caught with the roar on the door, the lag truck. Never had much before. My only thoughts was stack up. You either be the one making the punch or shooting smack up. Can't rely on niggas done. Keep quota- it done for- You want to know what it is, Rome Streets? You got the quotables, bro. You got them quotables. I see you doing your homework from Benny because Benny got them quotables. Rome Streets. He give you quotables, his rhyme scheme. Pay attention to his rhyme scheme, bro. Got caught with the raw in the door of the lack truck. My only thoughts was stack up. Punch or shoot and smack up. Keep your gun for backup. Look the judge in the eye and lie my hand on the Bible. Hey, shit. Yo, Dip got killed. Munch got killed. Pete got killed. Casablanca sealed. We ain't even healed before some more blood spilled. West Side Gun gets the memo too. Like, he's just, this is a reflective track, a reflective one, talking about all the homies that's dead and shit, and the stories in the streets, the hood tales, right? This is it right here, man. And once again, the piano beats, the beats that got the drums with the piano. You're never going to miss on those. I told you they always sound good. Yeah, good job, Larry. Good job, Larry. You're doing good, Larry. Keep going, Larry. Numbers. You gotta shout out Larry. You have to shout out Larry. Ray Ferraris with Larry June. Come on, man. You gotta shout out my man's Larry. You already know, baby. Hitler Wears Hermes hanging at the Louvre. I told you this is art. It's art. Because the next track we got is called Bye Bye. It's featuring Keisha Plum, and it's like a little like spoken word from her. That's like a official outro track. Let's be real. The real outro was that last one called Big Al, and that's solid, bro. Are you gonna do a Griselda by Fashion Rebels at the end? Come on, you gotta do it for the one time. You gotta have that tag for the one time, for real.
Well, the name of his favorite tape stopped with Hitler.
Ooh. No! How do you not put that Griselda by Fashion Rebels tag at the end of the project? You have to do it. You have to. How do you not do that? It's about art. Remember, it's about the art. What happened to the art? Damn, that shit hurt my heart. I'm spitting bars. My initial thoughts on side B is I like this shit way better than side A. Like, there's so many songs on here that I will revisit over side A. I think the features on here outperform side A, even though side A, I feel like, had like bigger names and shit. I feel like with side B, is this was more quality. This was more like top notch, everybody brought their best type shit. I gotta shout out Rome Streets off rip. Rome Streets is my favorite throughout both sides of this project. Rome Streets is the standout to me. He really blew my mind with his feature. I really don't think any feature on here, like, you can, if you go through all of them, nobody had a lackluster feature. The only one that I'm just gonna say, and I don't, it's not that I don't hate it, it's just the Stove Got Cooks hook on one of those tracks. His hooks just take so goddamn long sometimes, and that's it. But that's it. Other than that, Stove Got Cooks is my fucking guy. I feel like West Side Gun curated a better project than side A. And for me personally, this one I like more personally because there was not as much loops without any drums on them. So since there's 20 tracks on here, right, and three of them are like intro outro shit, out of the 17 tracks on here, there's maybe 2 to 3 that are just the loops with no drums on it. So for 14 of the 17 to have like real drums, real instrumentation, real production, grimy shit, the shit that we like, right, that instantly puts it above side A, because I just think there's more memorable and replay value heavy tracks on side B than there is side A. That's not to say side A sucks, it's just for the sake of me wanting to listen to this shit again and bump this in the whip in the car, right, I'm going to side B. I'll see y'all at side B, you know what I'm saying? I'll see y'all, I'm out of here. Like, I'm on side B with it. I'm not on side A for much of it. The only song on side A that I'm really listening to right now is Claire's Back and fucking Perry Rome Streets. Those are like the only songs I'm really listening to. That in the track with Boldy James. Like, I'm not listening to much songs off of side A that I'm gonna be listening to off of side B, because side B just, they can't correct. I don't know if I can throw out the word classic for side B, but I will throw out this is a classic for both sides combined. When you combine side A and side B, this is a fucking classic. Instantly. The curation on this on both sides is insane to me. To get these people on this project on both sides is ridiculous. I can't believe you get like J Electronica, you get Larry June, fucking 2 Chainz, you getting fucking the Benny and Conway still, you getting Tyler, you getting Jadakiss on side A, you getting Boldy James, you getting Sauce Walker, you getting Lil Wayne. Like, think about it. Like, to get these fucking people on these songs is crazy. And the direction of this project, I felt like, had a you know, it had a clear message is that this is the ending. So it's almost like you have to enjoy it. You gotta praise and appreciate it while you're listening. And that's, most certainly did that, bro. I try to enjoy it like this was the last one I'm ever gonna listen to, knowing damn well I still got all the other Hitler projects to go check out. But for me, I treated this one like the farewell. If you want me to give you a rating for side B, I'm gonna give an 8. Just off the bat, this one hits solid 8. Just solid 8. It's staying there. If you want to put the side A, side B together, I'll give that shit an 8.5 to maybe a 9. I don't think it hits a 9, but I think that shit's an 8.5. I give it a classic. You could, if you combine the two, right, and talk about them as one album, it might be album of the year. You know, it might be the project of the year. For real, got blessed, bro. We got fucking blessed by West Side Gunn, man. Let me know what side you guys prefer more. I feel like it's really up to the way you like your music at the end of the day. But I know a lot of people said side B was better, and I get why. Because I certainly do think it's better. If you made it this far in the video, shout out to you. I fuck with you. And if you've also made it this far, be sure you comment. It's about the art. Comment that in the fucking comments down below. If you made it this far in the video, comment that shit for real. You just gotta say it's about the art. It's all about the art. And you gotta put a caps on art. So if you guys enjoyed this reaction to Hitler vs. Hermes 8 side B, hey, please be sure you drop a like on this. I know y'all fuck with greatness. Please be sure you drop a like. Please sure you comment down below. You know the fucking vibes. Let me know what you thought of the project. Let me know what to react to next. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you are new to the channel. It really helps us grow. It really helps us get out there. You know what I'm saying? Really, it really helps us spread the culture. That's really what it's all about. Spreading the culture, spreading the art. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna stop saying art, but y'all know what I'm talking about. It's about this iconic shit. Hip hop. Real shit. Real rap. That's what we're about here. So please be sure you subscribe. Hey, turn on post notifications so you don't miss the new uploads. You know the fucking vibes, man. It's been your boy Unseen. I will catch y'all in the next video, man. Peace.